Now, something I've been seeing during the past couple of days are people saying that this pandemic is proof that libertarianism cannot work, and the situation we're in now somehow illustrates how we would all be hopeless or dead without the government. Now, this is a weird take. I've gone through, and many others have gone through, all the ways in which regulations and red tape were a serious hurdle for those who wanted to promptly react to this situation, and anyone who knows anything about reacting to a crisis knows that your initial reaction and how quickly you can pivot will determine whether you're successful or not. And it's odd that people would say this situation is damning of libertarianism, as it was directly the fault of government as to why we couldn't get ahead of this thing. Government was essentially forced to get rid of tons of red tape, requirements, and regulations for people to respond appropriately to this situation, which tells me that they bear much of the blame, and it also tells me that we don't need those regulations to begin with. Diminishing that red tape relieved the burden from those who are in a position to help. Why not keep that red tape in the garbage permanently then? If you don't need it in times of panic, or worse yet, if it actively harms people in times of panic, then how could it be helpful in better times? It can't be. Now, there is something that people seem to have forgotten, and that is that politicians grow more influential and become more drunk with power during times of panic and chaos. That is quite obvious when looking at how the federal government and many state governments are behaving right now. All in all, a crisis is essentially an opportunity for politicians to become little tiny dictators. You know that saying, never let a good crisis go to waste. Now, on the other hand, private businesses have an extreme motivation to end the chaos as quickly as possible and get things back to normal as quickly as possible. We've seen whiskey and vodka distilleries, as well as perfume companies, switching gears and creating hand sanitizer for people. We've seen TikTok donate millions of dollars to get food to families. We had people 3D printing valve pieces for ventilators for $1 a piece when they generally go for $11,000 a piece, which, by the way, using insanely stupid intellectual property laws, a medical device manufacturer is threatening to sue those people who just undercut them by almost $11,000 and could have potentially increased the supply of those ventilator pieces. Government legislation strikes again, I guess. What was that exactly they were saying about how this situation shows libertarianism is non-functional? That is the most baffling take anyone could have on this subject. Around nearly every corner, we see private businesses and private individuals innovating, retooling their efforts, and helping out where they can, while the government and the rules they are responsible for and the rules they put in place can be found blocking them every chance they can get. And what else have we got? We have Burger King just giving away 2 free kids' meals with any purchase made on their app. U-Haul is giving away free storage for 30 days to college students who have been displaced. And unfortunately, we have hotels offering rooms for medical facilities, honestly. And I say unfortunately because we're worried about a wave of more infections and the fact that we don't have enough hospital beds and healthcare facilities. Now, do you think we would have more hospital beds if a certificate of need was not required to open up a new hospital? Over the past however many decades, how many more healthcare facilities would we have if it weren't for the fact the government has stood directly in the way of those healthcare facilities being constructed? So people want to say this shows how libertarianism couldn't work? Well, as I said, that is truly a baffling take. We have unambiguously seen, as obvious as the sun, how government has hampered private efforts to move ourselves forward through this mess. And all of these regulations, laws, and political machinery that is standing in the way of doing what is necessary, these are things that libertarians, since time immemorial, have been saying we need to get rid of. And everyone looked at us as if we were crazy. And then when it comes time to panic, they start echoing exactly what we've been saying the entire time. This is too restrictive. We need the government to get out of the way. They're hampering our ingenuity and our ability to deploy resources effectively. And libertarians are sitting there saying, yeah, that's what we've been saying. Why is that only true when there's a panic? And tax relief is another one. People calling for tax relief. Okay, if you recognize taxes as a burden on everyone, why not permanently diminish that burden? If in times of panic, relieving people of taxation is beneficial, then imagine what that could do in times of more tranquility. So all in all, this entire horror show has unequivocally shown the government to be a massive burden on society, innovation, and ingenuity. And to the people saying otherwise, I just have no idea what planet you are on. But that is all for now. Please like, subscribe, and share this video, and take it easy.